Hello, I welcome you to this session of Python Oracle Connectivity. In today's session, we'll be discussing about insert option and create table option. So let me begin today's session. To insert a value into a table in Oracle, you know that insert statement should be used. And the execute function or execute statement is used to enter the record from the front end to the back end. Now, if you are inserting a single value, you need to use the execute statement. If you are trying to insert multiple values, then you can do two things. You can either use the execute statement within a loop, or you can use execute many statement, which is used for bulk posting of records. And the problems with execute statement within a loop would be that every time it will be making a trip to the database and would connect to database, and hence it is considered inefficient. This way of posting multiple records in a table. So while we are posting multiple records, multiple entries into a table in one statement, then we use execute many. And an entire list can also be transferred to a table. Like we have a list with us, list of values. In one execute operation, you can transfer that list to the table at the back end. And similarly, a CSV file can also be transferred to a table. So let me just show you how this is done. Let me take some examples for you. So yeah, so here I'm using the insert statement and the execute statement to enter values from my front end program, that is Python, to my Oracle table. So obviously the first basic steps would be the same, that is connecting to the Oracle using my username and password and then creating a cursor object. So this con here is a connection object and cur is a cursor object. So you can insert into the table using this insert into statement that you are familiar with, that you've used in Oracle. So insert into emp, I'm going to enter the values for emp number, ename and sal columns. So here in the values clause, I'm providing the values for these three. So this method would be when I'm giving fixed constant values. And obviously to put the values, to transfer the values to the backend, I need the execute statement here. And I pass this query, this variable stat, which contains the query, to this execute statement. Okay. Then I can do the same using the bind variables also, because which would be a better way of sending the values back to the table. And here I use the bind variables colon 1, colon 2 and colon 3, and I use a sequence to transfer the values so that the value 3000 is allotted to bind variable colon 1, couple to bind variable colon 2 and 5000 to bind variable colon 3. Now the most efficient way would be in fact to use the user input way. So here I am taking three variables A, B and C to enter the values for emp number, ename and salary. And you can see that since emp number and sal are of type int, so I am using the eval function so that it takes the input intelligently. And B is a string, so no need to use the eval out here. And then here the values to the bind variables colon 1, colon 2 and colon 3 are A, B and C respectively. Remember one thing, since the commit is off by default, auto commit is off by default, so insert is a DML statement. So if I don't write this con.commit, then these values won't be transferred to the table in the backend. In case of DDL statements, this statement is not mandatory, that is con.commit. But in case of DML statements, you need to send a signal to the backend so that the values can be saved, and that is done through the commit function. Okay, and after that, once it is done, then you can close the cursor object and the connection object. So if I run this program now, then from this query, the values, this would be entered. And from the bind variables style of query, these values would be entered. And from the user input and bind variable style of inputting, inserting values, the values which I provide from the runtime would be entered into the table at the backend. That is my table M. Before I run this program, let us first see the status of the emp table. So here I've connected into my account, and we just display the values from the emp table which are already existing. So we are having 14 standard rows of the emp table, And once if I run this program now, then three more rows would be added to the mtable. One, this row, second, this row, and the third, whatever values of A, B, and C I provide. So let me run this program for you. And remember here that I'm entering the values for names in lowercase, Sanjeev, Kapil, and so let me run this now. So the first two queries have already resulted in the value being inserted. The third query, of course, requires the values from my side. So I'm going to give the values as emp number 8000, ename as, let me give it in lowercase, Pooja, and salary as 7000. So no message is there. That means the program has ended successfully. Let us now go back to our SQL and once again list the contents of the table. Now you can see that the three rows have been added. And kindly see that the values of the enames were there in lowercase, but they have come here in uppercase. Because if you remember in one of my previous videos, I created a trigger which always converts the name that I enter into ename column in uppercase. So that is why they are automatically converted to uppercase. So let's again visit our program and see how this has been executed. I'll just review it, the things that I've discussed with you. First, the connection object, then the cursor object so that we can write the queries. Then the first query I've written, insert into M with these three columns and values. So when I execute this, the values are transferred to the backend. The values are transferred and saved in the table only when this con.commit is written. Otherwise, the values won't be transferred because commit would ensure that the values are saved there in the backend table. The second method would be using the bind variables method, where instead of the values, I would give the bind variables and their values I would provide in a sequence. I've done it here. It can be provided using a dictionary also, as we have discussed in our previous lectures. And another way which I would consider a better way is to have the input from the user. So use the input statement and then transfer the values into the table. So that's all for this session. In the next video, I'll be discussing the create table statement and I'll be discussing the inserting of an entire list into the table. Till then, thank you.